Alright guys, so once our project gets created, then we can open it up and have a look at it. So for right now, I'm going to close PowerShell. I think that's the last we'll be using that. We're going to open up Visual Studio Code now. So you guys should have this installed. Now, this is the welcome screen. I need to move it over a bit, I guess. So what we're going to see here is a list of recent workspaces and then a section up here to start. So I'm going to click Add Workspace Folder, and that's how we're going to get started. Now what you're going to do is navigate to your projects directory, select the folder that we just created when we used the Create React App command, and you're going to hit Add. So on the left-hand side here, this is the project structure. So node modules is where all project-related node libraries get installed to. So if we scroll down here enough, there's quite a few. We're going to see React. So there we go. All right, so we've got React, we've got React Dev Utils, React DOM, etc. etc. So this is where node libraries are installed to. We are never going to, well, I say that, we're going to try never to modify any of these files, because when if we move this project to another computer, this directory won't be here. This is our package.json file, and what this holds is information about the app as well as dependencies. So here we can see React, React DOM, and React scripts. Now, I can't think, React Router, yeah. All right, so what we're going to do, just to show you guys right now how this works, I'm going to go to Terminal and click New Terminal, and it's going to open it inside my demo project. So I'm going to run a command here, npm install, and then React-Router. You guys can do the same. Now this is going to install it to the node modules, but it's not going to do anything with this package JSON. So this file is very important when you're working in a repository with other people. If you're working on a section of an application and in order for it to work you need to install a few libraries, you want this to be updated so that your peers and coworkers can just, in this directory, run npm install. And what this will do is it will go through dependencies, dev dependencies, and it will update or install accordingly to what packages are listed here. So in order to install a package that's not here and save it here, we're going to do this. We're going to type npm install space, and then the package name we want to install, another space, and then dash dash save, and hit enter. Now there's actually, while this is installing, I'm going to show this to you guys. There's a great website for npm, and you can search packages here. So if I search React, we can see React Redux. We're going to be working with this. React Router, Router DOM, React Scripts, etc. A bunch of React applications. And actually, React Strap. If this lets us write Bootstrap, oh, it does, in the form of components, this is what we are going to be using for our application. We're gonna write a calculator application once we learn enough to be able to do that. And so we'll be using React Strap at that point. Now, if I close the package JSON file, we can see it's been modified. It's also colored yellow, gold, because it's been modified, kind of brown actually. So this has installed React Router, and using the save flag, if I open this up, we're going to see React Router has now been added here with the latest version. So if now I give you this project, Which actually I'll host it on GitHub. But if you take this project and now you won't have a node modules library, I'm not going to be pushing that. That's huge. What you're going to do is in the demo directory, you're just going to type npm install. It's going to go through here and install all the dependencies for you. So that is all. The package lock JSON is kind of the current state of what's in node modules and what's required and stuff like that. We are never going to touch this except deleting it, as sometimes if you have a conflict or something's not working related to packages, you can delete that and then run npm install. It's going to install it. We have gitignore, which has been added to ignore certain files, and here you'll see we don't include, so this, when we push to GitHub repositories, this ignore file will selectively ignore files, so it won't push them. So we're not going to push log files to a project's directory, we're not going to push a build or the node modules. So this is why the node modules library or directory will not be in any GitHub repositories that you guys that I pushed to GitHub for you guys in this course. Now moving on, we have two directories, public and source. The public directory is used for content that there's two parts to this application. There is the HTML file that has the title property and the, you know, CSS JavaScript files imported, and also a mount point called root. So this is where our React application is going to mount to. So we will not be touching this file very often. It's just there. Now also in the public directory, we can make an images directory, a CSS directory, if we want to, you know, hard code some links or scripts into our document. Now the source directory is where all the React goodness exists. We have service worker. We are probably never going to touch this. It should work out of the box. There's a logo. There is a CSS file and then an app CSS file. An index.js and an app.js and a test. So we'll cover tests later on in the course. For right now, the two files we're going to look at is index.js and app.js. So let's go through this here. So in ES6, which is the JavaScript implementation we are going to be working with in this course, you can import from libraries. So React from React, I'm going to show you guys how this works. So the statement import React, it's looking for an export from this library. Now you can also do relative imports, which we'll talk in a sec, but just to give you a rough idea of what an import is, I'm going to go find the React directory again, and I'm going to open up index.js. Now as you can see, there we go. Alright, so import React from this library. What this is doing is it's opening up, oh, I lost the other one now. Alright, bear with me here. We'll get this sorted. There we go, I've got both files open. That was tough. Alright, so what this file does, the React file that it's referencing here, is it's exporting a JavaScript file. So if I open up CJS and let's just look at React development, this is going to export as well. So we're never going to touch this It's the React library itself. But if we go down to the bottom, we see model exports React. So this is being exported to here, which is then being exported to our main index.js file. And from this, we can import React. So that's what an import looks like. Down here, so if we're working with libraries, this is what we're going to do. You can also import from relative sources. So this is attempting to import a component called app, or a class called app, from the app.js file. You don't need to add .js to the location of the export. So if I open up app.js, we'll see class app extends component. This is what we're exporting. But this just builds it. It doesn't export it. If I scroll down to the bottom, we're going to see export default app. And this statement exports it so that it can be imported here. Are we good? All right. So then we use React DOM to render a component to an element. That's as basic as it gets. So we're getting the element by ID root, which we saw in the public directories index.html file. And we are putting this React component there. So if I open up the app.js file, whatever's in the render method is going to be imported here, which we'll cover in the next video. We'll cover writing applications and components. So that's all there is to this video. That's the project structure of a React application for the purposes of this video anyway. We'll get more into it. Now, to run the application, which we're going to end with, you're going to type npm start. This is probably going to open a tab in your browser. Which it did, but it was the wrong one. It didn't tell me what port it's at. Okay. Oh, it's 3000. Okay. So once it compiles and loads, it will host it on localhost port 3000. And this is what we see. That's what the app.js file renders. So in the next video, we're going to delete this app.js file. We're going to build our own component, and we're going to mount it in the index file.